The entire Marvel Cinematic Universe has pretty much been built around the Infinity Stones. Often called Infinity Gems in the comics, these mystic superpowered gems have shown up in almost every Marvel Cinematic film to date, and it's all been leading to Infinity War. These powerful little rocks have the power to destroy the entire Marvel Cinematic Universe, and Marvel fans have seen the big bad Thanos plotting to get his hands on them since the first Avengers film. Everything climaxed in Avengers Infinity War when he showed up just to take them all for himself. As the comic predicted, here's the full rundown of the history of the MCU's Infinity Stones. The Power Stone is a purple Infinity Stone that controls all destructive power in the MCU. It made its first appearance in the first Guardians of the Galaxy film as the Orb. It was used by Eason the Searcher. This was shown to us when the Collector showed the Guardians a video of Eason using the Power Stone to destroy an entire planet. It was later used by 9 unnamed cosmic beings as they attempted to share its power among themselves, but were eventually disintegrated by the power of the stone. It was eventually enclosed in an orb and hidden in Morag under the ocean, which recedes once every 300 years. It was later found by Star-Lord, who planned to sell it to the Collector. Later in the film, it was obtained by Ronan the Accuser, who attempted to use it to destroy Xander. However, he was stopped by the Guardians of the Galaxy, and the Power Stone was given to the Nova Corps for safeguarding. In Infinity War, Thor revealed to us that Thanos decimated Xander to retrieve the Power Stone and placed it within his Infinity Gauntlet. The current location of the Power Stone in the MCU is with Thanos in his Infinity Gauntlet. The Space Stone is the blue Infinity Stone that controls all space in the MCU. Its earliest location was in Odin's vault on Asgard. It was then brought to Earth by Odin and left there with Asgard's worshippers in Tønsberg, Norway. This was revealed in Captain America: The First Avenger. During the movie, it was stolen by Red Skull, who used it to make weapons for the war. It later transported Red Skull to Vormir when he tried to handle the Tesseract with his bare hand. While the Tesseract fell into the ocean, it was retrieved by Howard Stark while searching for Captain America and used for Project Pegasus. In Captain Marvel, it was revealed that Mar-Vell obtained it and hid it in a lab in space. Towards the end of the film, Goose swallows it and spits it out on Fury's desk on Earth. Moving on to the first Avengers movie, Loki steals the Tesseract and uses it to open a portal for the Chitauri to invade Earth. At the end of the film, Thor obtained it and took it back to Asgard to be placed in Asgard's vault. In Thor Ragnarok, before Asgard was destroyed, Loki took it and stole it with him on board the Statesman ship. Moving on to Infinity War, Thanos attacked the ship, shattered the Tesseract in order to obtain the Space Stone. The current location of the Space Stone is in the Infinity Gauntlet with the Power Stone. The Reality Stone in the MCU is the red Infinity Stone that can warp and manipulate reality. Its earliest location known and its user was Malekith. Malekith was soon defeated by King Bor, and the Reality Stone known as the Aether at this time was buried. Jane Foster accidentally teleported to its location by the Convergence, where the Aether infects her. Later in Thor the Dark World, the Aether was drawn out by Malekith, who absorbs its power and battles Thor. He is eventually defeated by Thor, and the Aether is given to the Collector for safekeeping. In Infinity War, T'Varn was attacked by Thanos at Nowhere, where he claimed the Aether and solidified it into the Reality Stone and inserted it into his Infinity Gauntlet, which he used to kidnap Gamora. The Reality Stone, along with the Power and Space Stones, are currently in the Infinity Gauntlet.
Now, reality can be whatever I want.
The Soul Stone was the most mysterious of the MCU's Infinity Stones prior to its eventual reveal in Avengers Infinity War. It is the orange Infinity Stone that can steal, manipulate, and alter souls. The movie reveals that Thanos once sent Gamora to find the Soul Stone, but she decided not to reveal that she actually found it on the planet Vormir. After Thanos captures her, she takes him there and they find that the Red Skull has become the Stone Keeper, revealing to Thanos that he must make a sacrifice of something he loves in order to possess it. After he kills Gamora, the stone appears to him. He then places the stone into his Infinity Gauntlet.
I ignored my destiny once. I cannot do that again.
The Time Stone is a green Infinity Stone that controls all of time in the MCU. The stone plays a major role in Doctor Strange. The stone is later housed in the Eye of Agamotto, which has been created by Earth's first sorcerer, and Strange is later trained to use its abilities. He used the eye in the final battle to rewind time and trap Dormammu in a time loop, forcing the demon to abandon his plans for Earth. Strange used the Time Stone's power in Avengers Infinity War to view millions of possible outcomes to the Avengers' battle with Thanos, finding only one reality where they actually succeed. Strange later surrendered the Time Stone to Thanos to save Tony Stark's life. The Time Stone may play a role in defeating Thanos in Avengers Endgame, with many believing Doctor Strange created a special time loop before his apparent death. Its current location is in the Infinity Gauntlet along with the other four stones.
There's no time at all.
Lastly, the Mind Stone is the yellow Infinity Stone that can manipulate minds, increase intelligence, and grant abilities onto individuals. Thanos gifted Loki the Mind Stone, housed in a scepter, to help him conquer Earth on his behalf in the Avengers. This allowed Loki to control the minds of Hawkeye and Dr. Selvig, and Marvel later revealed that the stone was even manipulating Loki. In Avengers Age of Ultron, the stone is revealed to have artificial intelligence inside it that is used to create Ultron. Ultron then takes the scepter to create a body for himself, only for the Avengers to steal the body back and upload Stark's AI Jarvis into it, creating Vision. Vision later finds himself a target of Thanos in Infinity War, who ultimately kills him when he retrieves the Mind Stone from Vision's forehead. His current location is in the Infinity Gauntlet. And that's the history of the MCU's Infinity Stones. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. Leave a comment of any theories you may have regarding Avengers Endgame. See you next time.